it's Jeff and Fiona, and as a parent, as a mommy, as a daddy, as a grandparent, aunts and uncles, anybody that is picking out food for kids, you got to make sure they're safe from anything that may cause an allergic reaction, especially at lunchtime.
And Golden Dupont.
Love yes. that.
Love that flair. It's such a cool last name. Is here with Texan Allergy to show us some allergy-free lunches that you can make for the kids.
Yes. So first things first, we have a little game for you guys to play to show us how well you know about food allergies. I have a feeling that Fiona's going to do a little bit better than you, Jeff.
Why?
So let's see.
I don't know.
We have 30 seconds. What? You'll have 30 seconds to grab from here, pack your lunch, and then I will assess.
So what do we pack? What do we need to pack? Stuff that...
Just don't get all nervous. You just pick from here. Pick what looks good. Pick what you think might be food allergy friendly.
Okay.
How much time do we have?
You have 30 seconds.
Ready? Here we go. Ready? 5, 4, 3, 2, one. Okay, go. All right, I'm going to think, you know, that's kind of good. Sure, yeah.
What looks good? Sandwich.
Oh, and some
fruit. You got to have fruit.
Oh, yes. Maybe a little bit of that right there. Okay, and then some of this.
Mayo.
Ooh.
Peanut butter cracker.
Yep. I do like trail mix. Okay, I'll do that.
I don't know if that'll fit in there.
And some blueberries.
Okay, 10 seconds.
Because I like that.
I'm going to get the rest of this sandwich.
And a hard-boiled egg.
Oh, wait.
That's great. I'm done.
Protein. Wait, I'm back.
I'm packed. You don't have to pause it.
Oh, good.
I'm packed. I'm ready to go to school.
Chips.
Oh.
Okay.
How did we do?
All right. You guys actually both did pretty good. You did not fail.
Oh, that's good.
Really?
Yes.
It's
you
like
did not fail. So let's look at this. Right now, we have this peanut butter sandwich. It's not really a peanut butter sandwich. It's sun butter. So this is what we have to know, is that food allergy friendly lunches don't have to look different than other lunches. This is sun butter. You can use almond butter.
Really?
Looks like peanut butter. How does it taste?
It tastes like a peanut butter and jelly sandwich.
Yeah, exactly.
Kind of sounds like I'm eating a peanut butter and jelly sandwich.
It does. So there you go. That is actually food allergy friendly.
Okay.
The egg, not a bad food, but something that you want to watch out for because other kids can have an egg allergy. So while a hard-boiled egg is actually a healthy food, it's a good food. Not sure how it turned blue.
Well, this came.
Your egg's patriotic.
Well, this came from the Easter Bunny, apparently. It's a little early. But there's N and M's down in there, and that got
So, this was a trick because actually both of you selected it. It looks like it would be a bad food, right? Because it has M&Ms in it. It's actually okay. Lots of places are peanut allergy aware. Nuts actually are okay. So this is a good food.
Okay.
You have blueberries, those are good. Strawberries are something that you would need to watch out for. So it's just keeping your mind aware of what you're choosing here. This is a peanut butter cracker. So you would obviously want to be aware of that. You might have a child that has a peanut allergy. Something like this is a wrap using a corn tortilla, so we're avoiding bread for gluten allergies. Something to be aware of.
So real quick before we go, if your child has a food allergy, what are some ways you can treat that?
So you would probably know if your child has a food allergy just because of reactions. Reactions are typical allergic reactions that we would see anywhere, but more severe. So you can obviously take them in to get a test. We test and treat for food allergies.
So you're the place to go to find out.
Yes, Texan Allergy and Sinus Center.
Okay, and that over there is what you can, what are those allergy drops?
Yeah, those are allergy drops. And so what we do for food allergies is we give allergy drops, and that does not cure food allergies. So it's important to know that. It does make the reactions less severe.
Okay.
So you don't have to be carrying an EpiPen around, don't have to be worrying about anaphylactic shock if your child eats a peanut butter cracker.
And you should know all this as a parent to be safe, and you should know about little kids that come to the house too. And if you go to SALive.com, you can find out more on how to prepare those allergy-free meals and educate you and the other parents and everybody in the classroom, because birthday parties and all, you gotta be careful. Gotta take care of everybody. But you can come and find out what you're allergic to at Texan Allergy. And you go to SALive.com.